What's up, everybody? Happy Thursday. It is another beautiful day here in Southern California. It has been really, really hot here. I'm lucky because I'm in Los Angeles, so not getting the sticky heat like they're getting in Palmdale and Lancaster, which is the high desert. So we're definitely getting some heat, though. It is a dry heat. So our summer has finally arrived, but it's always summer in Southern California. Even when we get rain, it's usually just a few hours and then the sun breaks out. It's very rare that we'll get like days or hours and hours and hours and hours and hours of rain. Anyway, so I am starting the next phase of my peer support, and this is all part of my unplugging HIV, and just my whole unplugging HIV, the tag for that, or the motto, is empowering a positive life. So whenever I do an outreach or whenever I put together a workshop for the residents down on Skid Row or for the other organizations that I support through the Life Kits, I really think long and hard about how it's going to impact someone's life. What are the benefits of this? I don't do something simply to do it. I want to make sure that what I'm doing helps and that it actually benefits someone. So when I started thinking about doing a book club, I was just like, well, I want to make sure other people want to do this. So I spoke to some of the residents and they were like, yeah, that would be so cool. And I knew all the residents weren't going to be interested in it, just like all the residents aren't interested in a lot of the things that I do. And that's the cool thing, is that whatever I come up with, I base it on what the majority of the residents say, and that's what we go with. And even within that majority, I don't always please everybody. The goal is to please as many people as I possibly can and impact as many lives as I possibly can in a positive, productive way. So with the book club, I knew right away that a lot of people would not be a part of it. So having said all that, the group of guys that are a part of it are by far my favorite residents there. Donald, Walter, and Mark. And Mark and Walter have, just like me, love Elin Harris. So we are starting, and this is going to be Donald's first book. So we're just all really, really excited about it. So I introduced it and I said, hey guys, I'm starting a book club if you guys want to participate in it. And immediately these three stepped forward and said, yes, we want to do it. I suggested some books, suggested a Richard Wright book. Of course, I suggested Elin Harris. And some other books, and we decided to go with the first book by Elin, which is Invisible Life. If you guys have not read a book by Elin Harris, please go out, treat yourself, do yourself a huge favor if you love to read, and read books by Elin Harris. I would suggest reading them in order, because with each book he introduces new characters, and old characters have, like, for lack of a better word, cameo appearances. So to get an understanding of the books, I suggest reading them in order. So we're starting with the first book, which is Invisible Life, and it's a great book. I remember when I first read the first couple of pages and then into the first and second chapter, I was just like, this is really familiar. It was immediately, I was just like, whoa, this is familiar. I know this character. I know these characters. I can totally relate to these characters. And it made for such a wonderful, wonderful read. And it's funny, anybody that I talk to that is reading or has read Elin Harris books, they always say they finished the book in a couple of nights, in a couple of hours. When I got this book, I read the first few chapters, and I remember, I think I was on chapter 4, and it was like 1, 2 o'clock in the morning, and I closed it, finished chapter 4, and I closed it, and I woke up, and I finished the book, because I was just like, oh my god, I gotta know what's gonna happen, I gotta know what's going on with this, and that's the same with every single book, except the last book I read from Elin, Basketball Jones. I was really, really slow at reading the book because he had passed away, and I knew there wouldn't be another book. So recently I got a text message from my friend Travis, the Wordsmith, and he told me, he's like, there's another book, Elin's got another book. So I am like super, super, super excited. Since we are going to read all the Elin Harris books, I am going to wait until we get, I'm gonna do my best to wait before reading that book so we can all read it together. So Kenji's book club kicks off this Sunday, and I'm so excited. And my girl Jen, Sagacious Girl, is an honorary member of the Kenji's book club. Hopefully, Jen, you can pick up your book and read along with us. And maybe when we get together, we could Skype you in. And then that way you could be a part of it. That would be so, so cool. So I'm really looking forward to this. We're having our first meeting on Sunday here at my place. I'm gonna cook. So I might do a cooking with Kenji video, and I might not. But I'm really, really looking forward to it, and I'm really enjoying what I'm able to create and what I'm able to put in place for people through my outreaches. So super, super, super excited about this, and really looking forward to reading Invisible Life again. It is a great book. So that's my video for today. I hope you guys are well. Once again, Kenji's Book Club, we are starting with a novel by Elin Harris. It's called Invisible Life. Go out and pick it up. Read it. Let me know what you think about it. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace and blessings, everybody. I hope you guys are well, enjoying your life, taking care of yourself, loving yourself, and being good. Peace and blessings. Bye-bye. So I have another honorary member of my book club, the first being Jen, Sagacious Girl, and the next being my girl, my ace, my boom, Black Lacquer, Jackie. So this is going to be so cool to do this. Once again, the book is Invisible Life by Elin Harris. Honorary members are Jen, Sagacious Girl, and Jackie, Black Lacquer. So once again, I'm kicking it off on Sunday with a early dinner and conversation with my three friends. And I'm going to see if I can figure out if I can do a Skype conference, and that way Jen and Jackie can be a part of it as a little. Jen and Jackie can be a part of it as well. That sounds like a drink, Jen and Jackie. I bet it'd be a badass drink, won't it?